It's time for your 2020 November market update. Hey there, it's Chris and Kristy Vallee with the Vallee team at RE/MAX Center, and we are here with your November market update.
And some exciting things happened since our last market update. As you remember, in the last market update, we said we would tell you what the experts are predicting due to the election results.
Yeah, so many experts are actually staying quiet because they are in a holding pattern. Of course, the housing market is still very strong here locally. There are some major cities like New York and some of the coastal vacation areas that are seeing decreases in sales and decreases in sale prices.
Yes, we have seen a slight decline in the number of buyer and seller calls in our own office. However, from our research and looking at what the economists are saying about the election results, many believe that the anticipation of what's to come is causing a lot of people to make more emotional decisions instead of rational ones.
Yeah, true. However, looking back at past election cycles where housing slowed in November, the market more than recovered in the months afterwards. So it's more like consumers are just putting the brakes on and kind of taking a hold and wait and see approach right now.
Well, let's get into what's going on here in our greater Atlanta market. Let's look at the latest stats and leading market indicators.
So the total homes available for sale in the Atlanta market is around 12,291, and the number of homes listed in October alone was 8,122. With 6,051 homes sold in October, you can see that in just 1 month, half of our available inventory was sold.
A new comparison we're sharing with you today is the average price per square foot. That's the living space divided by the sales price. And it's no surprise this time last year, that number was $122, whereas this year it has increased to $137. So it just is relative to our increase in our sales price of 17%.
So we're selling homes in record time. The average days on the market is just 30 days. And it's only taking an average of 10 showings before a house goes under contract. So we are truly in a seller's market right now, guys.
So with it being such a seller's market, why are so many homeowners choosing to wait to sell? So let's look at the latest survey put out by Zillow that shows 34% feel life is too uncertain right now. 31% have financial uncertainty, and 25% have concerns of COVID.
Yeah, when it comes to uncertainty, we understand that for sure, but we also want to let you know that many of the headlines you're reading right now are scary or whatever, but we want to help clarify what's going on locally in the real estate market for you guys. We want you to feel confident about your real estate purchasing decisions.
And with low interest rates, the real advantage in today's market is going to be for the move-up buyers. If you're looking to sell your home and considering moving, we would be happy to sit down with you and show you the advantages of selling in today's market.
And it's never too early to consider your first home purchase. We have a free home buying guide in the comments below for you to check out.
So that's it for this month's market update. As always, we try to bring you valuable information in these videos, so leave us any feedback in the comments below.
Yes, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please let us know, and we would love it if you would give us a thumbs up or subscribe. For more real estate videos, hit the bell to be notified when we post new content.